Afrocentric na wanyama pale, shout out. Majamaa mnafanya kazi poa. Mimi actually nimeshafika Nairobi. Nimefika Nairobi but I'm shocked because chenye nimejaribu kuangalia hapa, actually nimefika hapa nikajaribu kuangalia population Nairobi, naona ni 5.5 million. So yani nimeshindwa kai. Yani 5.5 million people. Kwani sisi tuko hii percentage yetu iko wapi? Hii percentage yetu tunaweza kuwa which percent? Which percent? I think kama hata tungekuwa na percent kama ya kitu kama tungekuwa kama 2.5 hivi, at least hapo ingekuwa vizuri majamaa. But naona ni kama hii watu wote wako tu hapa Nairobi, but kutokea ndio wataki kutokea. So mimi nataka tu kuadvise majamaa, si tuko na unaweza, si tushafika Nairobi tayari, tunajaribu kuangalia tu venye mambo inaenda. Alafu kuna story nyingine nimeiona mahali ya nasikia nikaa kufika matime fulani hivi barabara sijui kutakuwa na distraction ya traveling. So kama uko place mbali na Nairobi, tafadhali jaribu mapema ufike ndo usikutwe, usipatikane ukanini, because najua hivyo ndo hizo ndo njia zenye wanataka kuzitumia mostly. Alafu I wonder our army, because hao ndio wanalinda nchi, but sasa wameachilia nchi, magaidi wameanza kuingia wakitumaliza. Unajua sisi kitu tunafaa ku count our police accountable is that mtu ako na uniform, ako full uniform, but mtu mwenye yuko in a uniform, huyo ni jangili na hafai hata ku own any weapon. Hafai kuwa na bunduki wala na kitu chochote kile. So hawa watu wenye wanakuja na civilians wamejifunika, hao ni majangili na hao ndio wanafaa kudeal na wao vizuri. So majamaa, kama venye tumesema 8-8 kesho, tunaenda kama masoja, tunaenda kama masoja. Unajibebea vitu zako vizuri, unavaa vizuri ndio tukikesha huko kusikue na usiumie baridi ama nini, na usifikirie kurudi nyuma, because wakati tunasema turudi nyuma ndio wao majamaa wanatufuata hadi makijani huko wanaenda kutumada. So hakuna kurudi nyuma, venye tunaenda hadi hiyo siku watashuka. So majamaa tujipange vizuri, kila mtu apake vitu zake. But si atubebe vitu mzito yenye ni kama unaenda kuishi huko, hapana. Actually wewe jipange tu, kama ni kuvaa vaa vizuri, alafu tukutane hiyo 8-8 kama kawaida. Ruto must go, he's going down.
Tuonane 8-8 8-8 kesho. Thank you Jose, wamefika mambogi zimeanza kufika. Abdul, karibu kwenye mic.
Asante sana Afro. Good morning fellow patriots and fighters. My name is Abdulrahman. I am speaking and I coordinate and I fight from Mombasa. We stand tall on the shoulders of the heroes that came before us and fought against the white man's rule, who had taken our land, our resources, our dignity, the peace of our ancestors' mind. They couldn't have sex with their wives. They went to the forest. They slept many, many years away from their wives who were legally married to them, so that they could liberate their minerals, their resources, their land, their freedom, their dignity from the white man's rule. I call upon everyone, each one of us here. You're there saying you want to boycott 8-8 so that you can go and defend your peanuts salary that you get, 30,000, 40,000 a month from oppressors, oppressing capitalists. I want to call upon you to boycott everything, to set aside that date you had gone with your side chick, with your wife, with the woman in your life. If you have no dignity, if you have self-esteem issues because of the way the system is oppressing you, they are going to dump you for a man that is going to be of more quality. It is time for us to be to rise up. It's time for us to fight on this last day. We need to remind each other that this is the last day we are jobless. It's the last day I'm going to be poor. I'm going to be a victim of corruption. I'm going to be powerless. I'm going to be voiceless, cheap. This is the last day that I'm going to be shown through opulence of stolen resources. But I mean, I don't have anything to contribute to nation building. We need to take back our power, comrades, from corrupt and give it to people that can implement our dreams, our collective aspirations. Let us all know that we can also take part in nation building. I feel proud that we are in this struggle, and I want to remind everyone that even when our forefathers were fighting the white man's rule, not everyone supported them. And I feel so shameful that the likes of bloggers, Gideon Kibeka, shame on you here. And I want to condemn you and say the likes of others that are supporting the regime that is killing us. I want to say that even then, when our forefathers were fighting the white man's rule, there came people who were collaborators who used to sell their secrets to the white man and who derailed the movement. Were it not for you and your efforts, stupid people that are taking money from these stupid politicians, our struggle would have been shortened. I want to say that we are going to boycott those solar panels that you sell, those cheap quality, cheap low quality products that you sell on the timeline, and you think you can side with oppressors. We do not belong to selling our cause and betraying the path that we want. So I want to call everyone, let us come and reclaim our goals. Let us go, let us come and reclaim our lost glory. I want to address my brothers and sisters who are in the security forces. We are not up against you. Stop killing us. Stop condemning us and saying we are anarchists. You're being used by the oppressors to make us feel like we are disrupting peace. There is no peace within us. We are dead from inside. All you can be, all what you're doing is just you're facilitating our meeting with our maker. So the point that we are saying we would rather die on our feet than live in our knees, begging for jobs, begging for resources. We cannot even get good quality times with our wives because we are hungry. We cannot even feed ourselves. We cannot clothe ourselves despite having degrees in our cupboards. So I'm here to tell you, our brothers and sisters in the forces, do like what the Nepalese, what the Sri Lankans did, what the Bangladeshi did. They were removing those uniforms and joining the protests to bring change in their country, and change is coming. So we are fighting against your low-paid salaries when we go to the streets. When we saw that the system ought to favor everyone, even talking about you who failed in exams and joined these jobs and these jobs where you have to use your body to physically abduct us. So we want the system to come whereby you can upgrade your education no matter what grade you scored, so that you don't do dirty jobs to kill people on behalf of politicians who steal and do evil work to rape our economy and condemn us to a third world status when we have brains that can push us to first world countries. So we are not going to keep doing assignments for European and American kids in colleges because of the discipline of their leaders. They live in first world countries, but for us, with our brains and smartness, we live in that world where we are jobless and our brains can decay or keep decaying and on our book knowledge. So what I'm saying, what next? We can talk about what next when even today is a problem, when we don't know where we are going to eat in the evening and all that. And I'm sure you heard that they're saying on TVs that whatever the Gen Zs and millennials and the youths are saying is making sense, but what we have is implementation matrices. we need to step aside, and what we are saying is tomorrow we want to step aside so that we show you how you can implement a merit-based society. We want to show you how to implement a society where someone can dream and rise up to the level they want to be, because the system favors anyone who dares to dream and to rise and to be disciplined and consistent to work in line with their goals. So when we come here, we are not joking. We've already said goodbyes to our wives and our lovers and our mothers. We've told them we may not come back when we go tomorrow. We've already told our family members that we may not come back when we go, but we are going to show that our blood does not just get spilled for nothing. It must count, just like Rex Masai and those who went before us. So what you have to do is, when you kill us, you're just taking us away from pain, but we ensure that the damage or the agitation that we bring tomorrow will change our country forever. We are no longer afraid of dying and anything. So in short, my friend, so that I let anyone else to speak, is let us all come. And we've been told, let us have good rest today. Our forefathers, when they were going to war, they never even used to have illicit sex. They never even used to spend time in the market centers when they know tomorrow they have an important mission. So today, let us consecrate ourselves. Those who believe in prayers, let them pray to their maker. Those who believe in their traditional ancestral spirits, they talk to your ancestors. Tell them to keep your spirit firm and your body courageous to face all the resistance that we have to face. We are not alone, fellow fighters. Our comrades in Uganda are doing the same. Our comrades in Ghana are doing the same. Our comrades in Nigeria are doing the same. In Asia yesterday, I told you already, because in the League of Nations, we are always known as savages and the most useless and children of a lesser god. This is the time to prove ourselves, that our smartness, our education, our knowledge, our dedication, our resilience, and our hard work must count in contribution to our nation building. We're not just here to be mentioned as statistics. We make the majority of the population. No, we are not. We're not just here to be counted that the youth contribute this percentage of the population. We are not just statistics. We are actual human beings with brains who can lead the likes of Isaac Mwaura, have nothing to do for the country. The likes of the girlfriend Karen Nyamu that they appoint, they have nothing to do. And this is not a fight against women. We are very viable and very educated and very capable women led by Rabia here that can lead. We are not against women getting appointed, but it is women that are quality, that can contribute to the nation building, not just counting the number of Instagram followers that they have when they come to debating in the Senate when it matters the most. So guys, I call upon everyone. It matters today, it matters tomorrow, it will matter forever, it will matter for the people that will come after us, that we lived a courageous generation that contributed, that fought, that came out in numbers, that ensured that we were listened, and the reforms that we want, we already have them. We are not being asked what we want. We already have the reforms that we need, and inshallah, God willing, we are going to achieve our reforms, and we are going to live in a fair and accommodative society where everyone can be accommodated. Thank you so much, Afro. Thank you so much, Cyprian, for the platforms you've been giving us. Thank you so much, Rabia. Thank you so much for everyone who is here, who has given us their platform. Today is the last day that you guys are using this platform. Today is the last day that we are going, as a struggle movement, we have to call to rally each other. From today onward, we are going to be using your platforms as a way to celebrate you, to thank you for the role you played during our struggle. Guys, it makes no sense for us to struggle forever. It makes no sense for us to fight endlessly. We were fighters and soldiers prefer decisive and quick wins, quick wars that provide very deliberate and swift results. So I wish that we fight today and tomorrow, and the next is to celebrate and to rebuild our nation, to clean it up from corruption and the theft and the discrimination that has happened. Thank you so much. We celebrate you, Afro. We celebrate everyone that has taken part from the time we started. And when tomorrow and the day after tomorrow we win, we are going to know who was behind us and who was against us and who used to give us platforms. Thank you so much. We celebrate you. We are in Nairobi to ensure that we reclaim our country from thieves, and to ensure that we
we dedicate our country to the people that are going to derive us out of poverty and every real oppression we have faced. Thank you so much, everyone. Enjoy your safety journey from wherever you are to the CBD. We meet tomorrow and we liberate our country. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.